Hey guys, Northwest Adventure Rider here. So I am about to replace the chain on my bike, chain and sprockets. I ordered a new chain and sprockets off the internet the other day, and they came in today. So I'm not going to do a video on how to change your chain or your sprockets. There's about 5 million videos on YouTube already. But what I have found are videos of people that ride bikes. They have vlog channels and things like that, where they actually say that your chain doesn't stretch. I'm here to basically show you that it does stretch. There's what's called a tensile strength rating on your chain. And depending on the size of your bike and the amount of horsepower and how much your bike weighs, all these factors play into what strength of chain you need to use. On the XR650L, it's recommended that you have about a 7,200 pound tensile strength. Now you can buy a real cheap chain, O-ring chain, whatever, for, you know, 20, 30 bucks off of eBay or something like that. And people just see the O-ring part of it and they see new, and they've got this bike listed in the categories of bikes that it fits because it's a standard 520 chain. But then they don't check the tensile strength rating of it. And the tensile strength rating is somewhere like 4,500 pounds. Then the chain stretches and snaps, and they complain about that brand of chain. Well, it's really important to check the tensile strength rating of your chain. I always, when I purchase a chain, buy a chain that's rated at higher than recommended for the bike. For example, I buy my chains usually somewhere around 8,200 pounds. The bike requires a chain somewhere around 7,200 pounds. So the chain that I took off the bike was a Renthal, I always say it wrong. Renthal O-ring chain. And I'm not exactly sure how many miles are on the chain. It was on the bike when I purchased it. And what I'm replacing it with is a brand called Primary Drive. It's a brand that I don't have any personal experience with, but it has really good ratings on the internet, the forums and things like that. It is a little bit different design. It's an O-ring chain, but the links on it are different than anything I've ever seen before. So first I thought I would show you the difference between a new chain and a used chain. So this is my Renthal O-ring chain. This is the one I just took off the bike. And one of the things that you need to look out for on your chain is, even though it will actually look decent when it's on your bike, every now and then you need to just, you know, take it off and inspect it. And I regularly lube my chain with a chain wax, not a standard, just chain wax. That's what I use. But if you look here, you can see there's lots of play in the links. So that's not good. This is the new chain. This is the it's made by Primary Drive, and you can see what I mean by the weird links. It's actually kind of like a ladder on the inside. I don't know exactly what that is. Maybe it makes the chain a little bit lighter, but Primary Drive, Renthal, just a regular old Renthal chain, nothing special to it. It is their gold one, whatever that means. Okay, so here's a side-by-side of the chains, and you can see that the links are dead even here. On this is the new chain, this is the old chain. You can see the links are dead even, and as we pan down, you'll see that they start to become uneven. And about halfway down the chain, the Renthal chain is about a full link off compared to the new chain. The overall length of the chains, which I can't compare because the new chain is a different length from the old one because I ordered a different sprocket configuration. It's two links longer by the time it gets to the end. It's off by two full links. So your chains do stretch when they get wore out. So here's another thing to look at when you're comparing your old chain to your new chain. On the new chain, you'll see that it's
a nice fluid movement as I pick it up. There's not any kinking or anything like that in it. And when I pick it up and give it a shake, there's no noise. With the old one, as I pick it up, you'll see it's not uniform. That actually comes up in like chunks. And as I pick it up and give it a shake, listen. Sounds like a baby's rattle. So, anyway, and if you have any doubts whether your chain is good or not, take it into the local bike shop. They have pieces of equipment that measure the chain links and can tell if they've been stretched or not. When in doubt, just ask. Anyway, don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe.